Hey guys, Tech Timmy here. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to create multi-room music groups for Amazon Alexa using the You Know Who app, which I'm in already here. And so there's a new, Amazon has a new paradigm in terms of how it wants you to create groups. For those that have older groups set up, they may eventually stop working as mine did today. So I basically decided to start from scratch. The new model is basically it wants you to create rooms and then put your devices for each room in that group. So in the case of the kitchen, all of your smart devices in your kitchen, including your ECHO speakers, would go in that group. And then basically, if you want to have an everywhere group and have You Know Who play music everywhere, then that is basically called a combined room or group. So let's set up the rooms first, and then I'll show you how to set up the combined one. Also, if you're having trouble creating or recreating the everywhere group, I have a little hack that can help with that as well. So, all right, so we're going to say create room or device group. So I've already started on this. So I've got my kitchen done and my living room done, but I do not have the bedroom done. So we're going to create the bedroom next. And so basically, these aren't your current groups, which can be a little misleading. So Amazon suggests a list of common names that people use. So, you know, for instance, I don't have a basement here, so I would never set up one called the basement. But so the one I want to set up next is called bedroom. So I'm going to do that. And then so add devices to bedroom. So these aren't necessarily your multi-room music speakers yet. But I have an air conditioner in my bedroom. Bedroom lamp is in the bedroom. Colleen is a lamp that I have in the bedroom. The Dojo, I think, is dead. The HP LaserJet Pro, I don't really want to associate with You Know Who here. Ice Machine, no. Kitchen Shade, no. The lamp is in the bedroom. Main lamp is also in the bedroom. And then Master Bedroom Shade is, you guessed it, in the bedroom. And then microwave oven, no. And then my Echo Sub is, yes. And it's interesting that if you own an Echo Sub, Amazon wants you to select that separately from your Echo speakers, which we'll look at next. And then, so other devices, that's my vacuum. And then kitchen, I don't know why, just something. Oh, that's my kitchen light, so that's not applicable. And then tree is my Christmas tree during Christmas time. So, okay, so now it's here are your Alexa-enabled devices. Go away, you. Except for the sub. And technically, the sub is not Alexa enabled. So, yeah, so there is that. So, okay. So now I've got to figure out which. I have a whole bunch of devices in the bedroom. So we got to figure out which ones we're going to add here. So my Echo Dot 5th Gen is here. My second Echo. Where is that? That is. It's here. Echo Show 5 second gen is going to, nope, that's going in the bathroom. Echo, my second Echo Studio, no. Third Echo is not here. Echo Dot is here. Echo Dot Clock is not. Echo Flex, Echo Pop is not. So Echo Studio, so that's one of my main speakers that I wanted to make sure we got. My Echo Show 8 third gen and second gen I have on my bedside tables in the bedroom here. So that's right. And then Portal Plus is dead. I need to figure out how to get that off of here. But so that's it. So basically now I've added my smart devices on the previous screen. And on this screen is where you want to add your Alexa devices. So I'm going to say next. I think that pretty much covers all the devices I have in my bedroom here. Like I said, a whole bunch of them. Now, bedroom is ready. So now I can play music specifically on the bedroom group, but I cannot play it everywhere in my crib just yet. So I'm going to say done here. And then basically what I want to do is I want to go back and review all of my groups. So we have bedroom, kitchen, living room, show subby. So that's my show and along with, that's paired with an Echo sub. So that's a whole separate thing. And then I also want to create a group for bathroom. So why don't we just go and do that together real quick? There's only one device in the bathroom, so this one should be relatively easy. And then create a room or device group. And I'm going to say next. And then this one we're going to call the bathroom. And then we're going to say next again. And devices not in groups. I don't have any smart devices in my bathroom, but I do have one Alexa device that I want to add. So we're going to say skip the screen. And then here, it's my this guy here, second Echo Show 5. Second gen I have in the bathroom. So next. So there we go. So now, if I go back to my devices, I'm going to have bathroom, bedroom, kitchen, living room, and eventually I'll add my deck, and maybe I have a dining area here that's really technically part of my living room, so I might want to group those out separately later. But so, as you can see, there's no master list like the everywhere group, which I had formerly, which I like, and I want to call it everywhere again. So now we're going to say see all groups. And then here we go. And then basically we want to go back to create a group. And then now we want to combine rooms or groups. So this is kind of the new paradigm. Before you could create everywhere and then have these separate things, this is really the way Amazon wants you to do it. So combine rooms or groups. And then as you can see, example there, you know who play music upstairs, blah, blah, blah. So now I'm going to say next. And then name the larger area. So I want the larger area to be called everywhere. And let's see, if this errors out, maybe it won't, everywhere. If this errors out, I have a little hack that we can try. So I'm gonna say next. Yeah, name can't be used. So it doesn't like that. It does not like the everywhere group because I used it previously. But someone gave me a tip online here. We can just say everywhere, and I'm going to put a space between the words every and where, and that little hack should work. Now add rooms. So it did work. Interesting. So now add rooms or groups to everywhere. And basically I want, when I say play everywhere, I want all of my rooms to be included in the everywhere group. So all of my speakers in the whole crib will go at the same time. I can also control them separately by saying, you know who, play music in the bedroom, and it will just play in the bedroom. Kitchen, it will just play in the kitchen. Living room, it'll just play in the living room, and so on and so forth. I have more than three devices in the living room, so I'll have to go back and add those other ones later. But next. And if all goes according to plan, it should say everywhere is ready. So that's it. That's how you do it. So now you can say Alexa, play music everywhere, and she will play on all of the speakers associated with those groups. So it's basically like a new container-based model where, like I said, she wants you to put rooms inside of the larger groups. And so if you have multiple rooms upstairs, for instance, you would do a similar thing where you identify the rooms in your upstairs and then group them into a master group called upstairs. And so that's basically it. I hope this video helped you. If it did, like I said, definitely a little bit of a different paradigm than I was used to before, but I like that it's very well organized once you get it set up. The everywhere thing is kludgy, where if you want to have everywhere as one word and you had that group set up previously, it may not work. You may not be able to get it as one word, but the command is the same if you separate the two words, which I think is brilliant. I saw that online in an Amazon forum. So if you ever come up with that and you're watching this video, thanks very much for the tip. And hope this video helped you. If it did, wouldn't mind giving me a thumbs up. Helps out the channel a lot. And hope to see you in the next video. Cheers.